What's going on YouTube? It's Astronaut H and I'm here with another video. But before we get into all that, I'd like to ask you guys to do a few things for me. Could you please like this video, subscribe to the channel, and please hit that notification button so you can know anytime a video is being uploaded to the channel. Now that that's all out the way, I'm here with a video or my opinion on what I think, you know, some sneaker brands should do going forward for their future releases. Basically for me, since we definitely come into the time of year where your footwear is, you know, like key, you know, even though like some of us footwear is key, more likely than not it sets off the whole outfit per se. But what I will say for me, I'm just thinking about like the way that the sneaker game has went, because we dealing with like bots and many other things. You know, we've came a long way from like standing outside for shoes and raffles, in-store raffles, so to speak. So for me, I honestly think like I've seen this with like high-end brands, and I was thinking like, okay, well, if high-end brands do this, then why not Nike, Adidas, you know, and several other brands that know when hyped up releases are coming out? Why don't they do this? And I'm speaking from my personal experience. This might not be how everyone else is feeling, you know. And smaller brands do this also. So what I was thinking, as before I made this video, I was saying to myself, how would it be if, per se, brands like Nike and Adidas actually did a pre-order process? I mean, it seems like the more logical thing to do when it comes to releases, so everybody is able to get a pair, even if the stock sells out, even before the actual release date. A pre-order process would make things run a whole lot smoother. How many of us wake up, you know, on a Friday or a Saturday morning hoping to be able to actually purchase a pair of sneakers? Like, actually purchase, just you wish, you're wishing, you're hoping that, you know, you're lucky enough to able to spend your money. Like, this is where we're at today. We're at the point where we're hoping and wishing to spend our money on sneakers. Think about that. Like, you actually wake up, go on the sneakers app or Yeezy Supply or the Confirmed app, and you hope you can win the draw. You hope you're in the queue and you get selected to actually purchase. Like, think about that. Like, think about how far we have come from the days of standing in line, online, in-store raffles, and so on and so forth. Like, we're so far removed, and now we're dealing with botting. We're dealing with backdooring. We're dealing with so many ways that we're not able to obtain these pairs of sneakers that we actually want to wear, some of us. Others, you know, they have their choice of what they choose to do with their shoes. Me per se, I've been missing a lot. I'm not gonna lie, I haven't scored on the Confirmed app yet. You know, the new 450 slate is dropping. I believe the dark slate is dropping tomorrow, which is Saturday, because I didn't score on Yeezy Supply. They were actually gone in 8 minutes, so they were already gone before I even had a chance to sniff them. I couldn't sniff the glue. But let's just get into, how would you feel if we actually came to a pre-order process? Brands that I like, brands that, you know, some brands, the brands that you may have seen me review, you know, shoes on this channel, Saya Collective. That's the way I obtain a lot of pairs that I do have, is through the pre-order process. You know, I don't score on the Saturday. I don't score on the Saturday when they released, because it's just like everybody is feeling the same way. You want to cop a pair. You know, I would love nothing more than to be able to get a pair on a Saturday. I would love nothing more than that. But I'm just not quick on the draw like everybody else, man. I salute that. But thank God for the pre-order process when it comes to like brands like Side Collective. And so many other brands are doing a pre-order process. That's why I said, like, what's stopping a brand like Nike from doing a pre-order process? Like, think about that. We're talking about a $1 billion company, and they don't even want to do a pre-order process. Think about that. All the dunks that they release, all the foam posits, all the limited releases, all this et cetera, with the hype and the Travis Scotts and the collaboration, the fragments. Just think about all that you go through. And then they don't even want to, like, give a pre-order. Like, a pre-order process will alleviate a lot of the BS that you have to go through on the secondary market. The GOAT app, the StockX, the eBay. It will eliminate a whole lot of that. And I understand when it comes down to them and how they want to run it, you know, if it's not limited, not too many people is going to want it. But I believe the people that really want the shoe are going to obtain the shoe, no matter the cost. But it comes down to the fact of the matter that why, when a shoe retails for, let's say, let's just use an example, like a foam runner. Foam runner retails for under $100. Cool, that's fine. But it resells for almost $400, depending on the colorway. So think about it, though. Kanye wants to make the shoe under $20. The shoe retails for a little bit over, excuse me, a little bit over 60. Then you have to deal with the resale market. So if you even able to obtain a pair, it's almost nearly impossible. Think about that. Think about it. It's almost nearly impossible. And all that's keeping us and the bots from battling it out is a pre-order process. Think about a pre-order process. I done seen Saks do a pre-order process. Nordstrom's do a pre-order process. I done seen a lot of high-end brands do pre-order processes for, you know, items. So what's stopping them? I believe in my heart of hearts, they will never do a pre-order process because that loses the hype on the sneakers. And that's a shame. That's a shame because everybody that should want a pair should be able to get a pair. I'm not paying upwards to $1,000, $2,000, $3,000, $4,000 for a shoe that costs them all but, what, $3 to make? If we being honest, $3. So let's just call it what it is. They're playing the game just like us. You have the resale market. You have the secondary market, the GOAT app, StockX. So it's all one big game. And I feel like the average consumer, like myself, is at a disadvantage. Like, where I feel like once in-store started dwindling, it put us at a disadvantage for the average person to actually be able to grab a pair and have a pair just like that, like go in store and purchase. So right now is, again, like I said, I feel like we're at a huge disadvantage for the average person to be able to obtain a pair of sneakers. The sneakers that they want, per se. Maybe I'm wrong, but again, like I said, a pre-order process goes a long way. Everybody's happy. They obtain what they want. They get their shoes. You know, 3-4 months down the line, hey, at least you know it's coming. At least you know what's coming. And you don't have to worry about, oh man, I didn't score. And then you like, who wants to pay $300 extra already on retail? So the shoe retail for $200. You know, they asking $500, $600. Like, if you lucky. I want to say this. I want to say that, yes, the pre-order process is time. It's more or less of, do you want to wait? Some people are impatient and they are willing to pay that extra, whatever it may be. For me, you know, the pre-order process, set it and forget it. That's my motto. You know, just set it, forget it, pay, and then just wait for it in the mail. You know, whenever it comes, it comes. And then me, I pre-order so many shoes from particular brands that I forget which ones is coming when and how many I got. And but again, man, this is where we at currently. This is where we at on the sneaker culture, and it's a shame. It's a shame. I feel sorry for the new cats that want to come and collect and just have pairs. It's much different than what it was years ago. You know, again, man, give me your take on it. Do you like the, would you rather see big brands do a pre-order process? Are you okay with how the process is now? You know, just drop a like, you know, drop a comment, subscribe to the channel. You know, go follow me on Instagram, please. You know, at Astronaut H. And I'll catch you guys on the next one.